Joining me today in the Proactive Studio is Lunnon Metals Managing Director Edmund Ainscough. Edmund, thanks for joining me.
Thanks, Megan.
Edmund, you've struck high-grade gold at two prospects at the Foster Baker Project within the Kambalda Nickel Project. How do these high-grade gold hits at the Lady Herial and Plentiful prospects align with the company's overall strategy for the Foster Baker Project?
Well, we've been quite public and we've messaged that we've finished a lot of the nickel drilling we needed to do. We've obviously had a strong nickel focus since we listed in June 2021, but obviously there's some pretty negative sentiment around nickel. But aside from that, we had finished all the nickel drilling we needed to do at Foster Baker. So it was a very easy pivot for us to switch to looking at the gold potential. Kambalda is a very world famous nickel district, but it's also St. Ives is also an incredibly famous and well endowed gold project. And we're very blessed to have 19 tenements right in the middle of Goldfields St. Ives project. So we switched to a little bit of gold drilling. We tested five or six targets earlier in the year, and we picked Lady Herial and Plentiful to be the two we took around for a second round of drilling. And I'm really pleased, obviously, that we're continuing to hit high grade results. So it fits into a strategy of preserving our cash in difficult times for nickel, but hopefully finding high value near surface prospects for gold that we can turn to account in the short term.
And I'd imagine that the current high gold price is a welcome development. What does that mean for your exploration and development plans at the project?
Well, we, again, very, very lucky. We're on granted mining tenements. I worked at St. Ives for WMC and Goldfields starting about 25 years ago when I was the chief geologist at St. Ives. The gold price was about $360 an ounce Australian. It's now $3,500, so 10 times as high. Obviously, costs have gone up, so that's not all profit margin, but it is still a very healthy Australian gold price. And you'll see typically companies are mining with a roughly an average margin of somewhere between $1,000 and $1,500 an ounce. So while times are a little bit miserable, a little bit negative in nickel, again, having this ground in the middle of St. Ives, being able to bring something near surface to account very quickly has the opportunity to potentially be quite rewarding. So it fits very neatly. The gold price obviously is very encouraging, but really for us, it's making the most of what we've already got on our tenement package.
And given the notable assay results, what are the next steps in your exploration program to further assess the potential of the near-surface gold deposits at these prospects?
Well, as I said, Lady Herial and Plentiful were the two targets we selected for a second round of drilling. Plentiful has got a little bit narrower, and it looks like the potential at Plentiful might be a little bit deeper than we originally estimated. Lady Herial, on the other hand, just keeps getting better and better. It's very near surface. We put a plan in the announcement today showing all of the great results, multiple high-grade hits, all within 30 metres of surface. So the next steps for Lady Herial would be to plan a drill program to infill that spacing, looking for something a bit tighter so that we can look at the continuity of the high-grade and then hopefully create a mineralisation model, run an optimisation and see if we can get a small pit that can be permitted and move forward very quickly. So that's the next stage at Lady Herial, is to look to infill those great results we put out today.
And you mentioned your low-cost approach to the near-surface gold exploration at Foster Baker. Could you discuss a little more the potential economic and operational benefits of that?
Well, near surface obviously means shallow. It means we have very low strip ratio. So strip ratio is very important in determining what does and doesn't fly from an open pit perspective. And then the balance of the other side of that is grade. And Lady Herial appears to have some very good grade, appears to be associated with some quartz veins that were mined in the 1920s. Broadly speaking, that historical production from 100 years ago ran about 10 to 14 grams a ton. So the drill results we're getting are supporting that historical grade. Obviously, we need to look at the continuity of that. But the benefits, the economic benefits, if the grade is high and the volume is small, typically that leads to a nice margin. So as I said, we're on mining tenements. We can permit these things pretty quickly, as we've shown with our Baker on Cornerstone Nickel asset. So it looks like happy days. We've just got to get back in there and drill it and make sure it's as continuous as we think it might be.
Good luck. And Edmund, thanks for your time today.
My pleasure. Thanks for having us, Megan.